Welcome to Tech Reflex, where we don't exclusively benchmark hardware after having unboxed in our channel name. Today we are going to test the performance of affordable X570 motherboards from different manufacturers, and we are going to find out which is the one you should go for. Hey guys, I'm Siddharth, and let's start with this very original idea that I'm sure no one else on YouTube has done before. So today's contenders are the Gigabyte X570 Aorus Elite. Then we have the MSI X570 Gaming Edge Wi-Fi, the Asus TUF Gaming X570 Plus, and then finally we have the ASRock X570 Steel Legend with this interesting camo pattern. For our VRM temperature testing, we will use a Fentex P400 Eclipse, which is an older window case model, but it is really great for this testing as it will allow us to limit the airflow on top with these panels. We will do a stress test for half hour because this isn't an open bench airflow test. Then we will remove the side panel and test the peak temperature on the backside of the MOSFETs on the motherboard, which will give us a good idea about what is going on with the VRMs of these boards. We will use the AMD Ryzen 9 3900X as that will make the VRMs work the hardest and will give you an idea of the worst case scenario. So here are the results. And we can see that the Asus TUF Gaming X570 Plus is running the coolest at 54 degrees. And the reason for that is that Asus is using unusually high quality VRMs for their affordable lineup for this generation. I link to a video by Buildzoid who explains more about how these boards are just all you need to handle the 3900X even when overclocked. We have the Gigabyte X570 Aorus Elite on the second place at almost 4 degrees higher than the Asus board. But this is still good performance in comparison to the other boards. Then we have the ASRock X570 Steel Legend with a similar gap of around 4 degrees from the Gigabyte board at 61.5 degrees Celsius, and this is kind of unimpressive, so if you are going to use higher end Ryzen CPU, this will surely not be the best choice. Then finally, we have the MSI X570 Gaming Edge with surprisingly poor performance even though it has a very beefy heatsink. This is 20 degrees higher than the Asus board and 13 degrees higher than the worst of 3 at 74.6 Celsius. MSI is generally somewhere in the middle, but I don't know what happened to them this time. I think that it would be best to avoid this one for this generation of the AMD motherboards. Keep in mind that we only did a 30-minute stress test and we didn't overclock the CPU, so if we did a more extreme test, I am sure that we would see a more dramatic difference. So with all that into consideration, I don't think that there would be a reason to not buy the TUF X570 Plus, but if you already bought a Gigabyte motherboard, you also don't have to worry. By the way, make sure that you are subscribed to the channel with the bell because I have some really cool videos coming up. A cooler voltage regulator module will allow you to run your CPU at higher clocks for longer. And if the VRMs get very hot, your CPU will also throttle, giving you less performance than you expect from it. And lower temperatures will also give your components a longer life because heat isn't the best friend of PC hardware even though it is very hot. We only tested the VRMs this time, which took a surprisingly long time, but if you want to know more about the features of these motherboards, you can visit their official websites. My friend Vaibhav, who helped me with this project, is also using an Asus X570 Prime board in his PC, which he bought after recommendation of some Australians instead of taking advice from his friend who has a tech channel. Asus is also not being subtle about being the best this time, and they have the mentions of cooler VRMs on their website even though they didn't do the same during the Z390 generation. This also shows that you should watch videos like this one for each generation of motherboards that comes out to see which one of them is performing the best. So I'll have links to all of these boards in the video description if you want to buy one of them. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, or press the thumbs down button twice if you disliked it. Subscribe with the bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.